What was your favorite subject in school?
Reading. And you know what? I can't say computer. You know why I can't say computer is one of my favorite?
Because computer wasn't around.
Well, hi, Amelia. How are you?
Good.
Good. Are you ready to get started?
Yes. So let's start the question.
Okay, great.
What was your favorite subject in school?
I loved history, and I still love history, and I like to read books about history.
Oh, my favorite is maybe math.
Ooh, all the STEM programs are good things, especially for girls.
I love history. I love learning about how people lived back long ago in the Constitution and all of that. It's so interesting to me.
I like reading.
You do? Well, great. That's two of us.
What is your favorite childhood memory?
I can remember sneaking at bed at night with a flashlight, reading under the covers, and my mom fussing because I had the flashlight. Turn the flashlight off, go to sleep. I would know that she's asleep. Turn the flashlight back on and read some more. Growing up in McCalla, when I was a little girl out there, we were in the country. And we had a farm pond that we could fish in, and we actually went swimming in it. And that's where the cows got their water. Can you believe that?
My favorite childhood memory is going on family vacations. And we would go and visit other family members and play with my cousins and just have a great time with my aunts and uncles all over the country. We would travel so much, and it was just a lot of fun.
Okay, what you got?
Who is your biggest inspiration?
My biggest inspiration. I will say it was my grandmother. My grandmother was born in 1899, but she was quite a lady, and I think I'm a lot like her, which is a good thing, but she was no nonsense, but she had a big heart.
I have several, but I think the one that might be most impactful right now would be my mom. My mom is 87, and she lives with me. And she has such a positive attitude about life and about living.
What is the most difficult thing you've had to overcome?
I think personally, was when my mother passed away about 10 years ago. Even though I was a full-grown adult, it was still a hard thing, you know, because it's just, you love your mama, you love your mom, don't you? So that was a hard thing.
I lost my husband to cancer.
Okay.
34 years ago. Okay, long time ago. And then I had a new boyfriend that I lost 2 years ago of cancer. And then right after he died, I was diagnosed with cancer. So I think if I have to talk about overcoming, it would be the disease of cancer. I had chemotherapy, radiation, I lost all my hair. It's grown back. I'll show you a picture of Vera Bald when we finish, okay? My hair is back. But you know how I got through it? Staying positive. Knowing that there was light at the end of the tunnel and I would get through it, and I'm doing well. I am cancer free, praise the Lord, and yeah, I give all glory to God.
Last one. If you could give me one piece of advice, what would it be?
Oh my goodness.
I would say, Morgan, the best piece of advice I could give you is, if you don't already, you need to love to read. I'm a big believer, if you can read and read well, you can conquer the world.
Never stop reading. Anything. Everywhere I went when I was growing up, I had a book. And there was this theory in my family that if I read too much, I would drive myself crazy. Well, I guess I'm a 65-year-old crazy because I still read. Every night I have a book in my hand and I read before I go to bed. So always read, always be a learner, always want to know more.
My advice that I would give to you is to always trust yourself, no matter what. Trust yourself and believe in yourself when nobody else does. Because you know what? Because you believe in you, everything you hope, wish, and dream for will come true.
Let's do it.
Good job.
What did you think of meeting Miss Pam today?
but I'm so happy I don't know what to say.
That's okay, dear.
What did you think today of meeting this?
I kind of got nervous, maybe.
What's one thing you've maybe learned
today? That is very important to learn about somebody's life, maybe. And learn about how they grew up and all that stuff.
My mother used to have a phrase, and she said, it takes all kinds to make the world go round. And what she meant by that was, we're all these different people, shapes and sizes and colors, but we're all part of the world. And it's, hey, I've been excited all day long about meeting you.
All right.